So now it's time to start the experiment where we want to enrich the medium for arginine requiring mutants. Now on ice we have a exponentially growing culture that was growing in a medium without arginine. Now then we add the entire content of the tube into the medium in the water bath. Here we go. This is then time zero, so we start the clock. Immediately after starting or inoculating the medium, we have to do a measurement. We have our spectrophotometer and we start by zeroing it with a reference cuvette. Then we take 1 milliliter of the culture and in order to measure the optical density. So we stop the water bath, take the sample quickly, remember to start the water bath again, this should get rated, and then we add the sample to the cuvette. We measure the optical density of the culture, in this case it's 0.15 units. Now we plot that value into a semi-logarithmic plot. You can see I did a previous experiment, so you can see how it's supposed to go. So we start by plotting the first value, 0.15. The y-axis we have the optical density and the x-axis is the time. So you can take that 1 centimeter is 10 minutes and then you can plot the values and follow the growth. So let's plot the first value. When we reach 0.3, it's time to add the ampicillin. So that will take approximately 1 hour. It's not important that it's exactly 0.3, it should be around 0.3, so we should have been grown for at least one generation. So we have now reached an optical density of 0.3, so it's time to add the penicillin. But before we do that, we have to take a sample and determine the density of the culture, or the CFU in the culture. So what we do is we take a sample, it's 0.1 milliliter from the culture. Here we go. And we then add that to a 10 milliliter dilution tube. And from that we then dilute the sample and plate at the proper dilution. So after that, we're now ready to add penicillin. So we add penicillin, note the exact time, and down it goes. So now we mark at what time we add the ampicillin, and we keep following growth, the development of the growth, by measuring the optical density. Now after some time, you will hopefully observe that the growth ceases, and even you will observe a drop in optical density. Now this drop is a token of cell lysis, as lyse cells diffract light to a lesser extent. So it seems in this case as if the penicillin is working. Okay, so after some time, it's 1.5 hour, it's time to plate the cells. And from that we have a 2 milliliter Ebendorf tube, and to that we add 1.5 milliliter of culture. It can be done by pipetting 2 times 0.75 milliliters. Now in order to obtain equilibrium in the centrifuge, we have to make a counterbalance, or we can do it simultaneously with another team. If there is no team ready for centrifugation, you can make your own counterbalance by adding 1.5 milliliter to a second Ebendorf tube. So now it goes down into the centrifuge. It's important that it's balanced, so you place them opposite each other. A good trick is to orient the hinge, so the hinge will be pointing upwards or outwards of the centrifuge, because the pellet that may be formed is can at times be very hard to see, and when you do that, you know where to look. So you put on the lid and close the centrifuge. In this case, you run it for 2 minutes at 8,000 RPM. So ready to go. After 2 minutes, the cells are spun down and you'll see them hopefully at the bottom of the tube. So you can see it here, but you can see the pellet, right? Hopefully you can. I can. Then you can decant the medium into something. For instance, the old culture flask, because you're not going to use the culture anymore. So it's time to resuspend the cells, and for that you take physiological salt water at 1.5 milliliters to the tube. You can then resuspend the cells either by shaking or by punching it in the Burley mixer. And then it's time to plate. And what you do for plating, you take a direct plating and you do a 10-fold dilution and a 100-fold dilution. So we take a pipette and transfer 1.1 milliliter from our cells into sodium chloride, as you have been doing before. So that was a 10-fold dilution and a 100-fold dilution by taking 1.1 from the previous tube to a 10 milliliter sodium chloride. Here we go. You're then ready to plate, so you have your plates and you plate 100 microliter from the centrifugation tube, and 100 microliters from the two other dilutions. You then spread it as you've done previously with a Drygalski spatula, and you are then ready to go. The plates are then incubated overnight for 37 degrees, and hopefully tomorrow there will be a lot of colonies to look at. So next day, hopefully we'll see a lot of colonies. In this case, yes, it is pretty successful. There are lots of colonies to test. So what we're going to do is to screen the bacteria, the colonies, for an arginine requirement. So we have a plate with arginine and a plate without. In this case, it's a good idea to write on the side of the plate, because we will have a lot of cell material covering the entire plate. So we mark the plates with an arrow so we can orient it the right way and place it on the scaffold. Then we take single colonies with the toothpick, and it is very important that we take single colonies. If they are very close, these colonies are placed very close to each other, just skip them. It is important that it is single colonies. So you touch the colony and then you make a streak both on the plate with and without arginine, so you afterwards can see which one has a requirement. You keep on collecting colonies, keep streaking, and yeah. Now, after you have screened all used all the entire plate, you then have to incubate it next day. So You put it in the incubator for 37 degrees overnight. Now, hopefully you got some arginine requiring mutants and then purified on a LB chloramphenicol plate. So in this case, you got four different strains, and you want to transfer these strains to a liquid medium. We are a bit of a hurry, so it's important you inoculate at a very high density. For that, you use an inoculation needle. In this case, it's an old-fashioned one with a platinum head, but the plastic ones is even as good and even faster. So in this case, it's important that you have plenty of bacteria. So what you do is you're not picking a single colony this time, but you're actually taking a significant number of colonies. So you can see the bacteria on the inoculation loop. You then put it into the tube, and hopefully you will see that some bacteria has gone into the medium. Okay, so you then inspect, or you give it some, you see to that the colonies are properly dissolved, and then you inspect the tubes. You should be able to see a little bit of turbidity in the tube. If you cannot do that, you simply repeat it and take more bacteria from the plate. Eventually, you will see some growth, and you can, of course, compare with a tube without bacteria, so you can see the difference. In this case, it should be pretty obvious that you have got some turbidity in the right-hand tube. So this is fine. Then, of course, you remember to mark the tube, as always. Now it's time for the bacteria to grow for a couple of generations. So they grow into the incubator at 37 degrees Celsius.